As scientists, we spend a ton of time taking measurements.
How big is this thing? How hot is it? How much is there?
For gases like carbon dioxide, how much is there is actually pretty tricky to answer. We need specialized equipment to detect the concentration of carbon dioxide in the air. Also known as CO2, this gas is of particular interest to science because of the significant role it plays in our lives. We breathe it out as a product of respiration, and then the primary producers in our ecosystem, like plants and cyanobacteria, capture that CO2 and turn it into sugars via photosynthesis. And of course, the increased concentration of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere due to fossil fuel combustion is wreaking havoc on our planet through climate change. To measure CO2 concentration in the air, scientists can use a piece of equipment called a carbon dioxide gas sensor. Today, we'll learn how to use this sensor in the lab, and then we'll run a mini experiment to see how CO2 concentration changes over time when an organism respires. For this experiment, you'll need a carbon dioxide sensor. I'm using this standalone one that comes with its own display, but there are other models that can interface with your computer. A capped bottle that has a hole with a gasket for the sensor to fit through. These special bottles often come with the sensors when you purchase them, and the rubber seal of the gasket allows the sensor and bottle to be joined without leakage. And germinating seeds. I'm using mung beans today. Germinating means I've soaked them in water overnight and they've just started to sprout. First, I'm going to turn my CO2 sensor on. The display will show a reading in parts per million, or ppm. In other words, the number of CO2 molecules per million molecules of air. It automatically samples the air every few seconds for a fresh reading. When the sensor first gets going, the readings may appear very low. We need to wait until they get up to around 400 ppm, which is roughly the standard concentration of CO2 in fresh air. There we go. The sensor is now actively taking measurements of the CO2 in the air. You can see that if I breathe out near it, the concentration spikes as my exhale temporarily increases the CO2 in the air. While we wait for the reading to go down again, let's make some predictions. If the chemical equation for cellular respiration is C6H12O6 plus 6O2 yields 6 CO2 plus 6 H2O plus energy, how do you think the concentration of CO2 will change over time in a bottle that contains respiring seeds? Let's do our experiment and find out. First, I'm going to fill the bottom of the bottle with germinating seeds, put the cap on, and shake the seeds over to the side of the bottle so they're out of the way. Then I'll insert the sensor through the gasket. The seal from the gasket prevents air from entering or leaving, so we're only reading the carbon dioxide levels inside the container. In the current display mode, the sensor is actively sampling the air and showing the readout in real time, but we want to go into experiment mode so that it records readings at regular intervals. This way, we'll be able to keep track of how the CO2 concentration is changing over time. To do this, I'll press the graph symbol and then press the triangular play button to start data collection. The sensor will record CO2 readings on this graph once every 4 seconds. We'll run the experiment for 10 minutes. Okay, come on, seeds, you can do it! Let's go, let's respire! Woohoo! When 10 minutes are up, the sensor will stop recording and I can see my final graph. Wow, my seeds did such a good job respiring! We can see that CO2 steadily increased over the course of the experiment and reached a final concentration of 2,652 parts per million. Whoa! This device also has an option for exporting your data to a USB drive so that you can explore and visualize it on your computer. Well, now that you know how to use this handy CO2 sensor, I hope you have fun dreaming up some cool experiments to measure changes in CO2 concentrations.